You're probably killing the quality of your mix because you're forced to mix in your bedroom. And I've got nothing against your bedroom. I'm sure you got a cool bed, some posters of moose on your wall, but I want you to answer this one question. Would you rather be mixing in this nice studio that's acoustically treated with big expensive speakers, with no mom downstairs or neighbors next door yelling at you to turn down the volume? As great as all of that sounds, unfortunately, that's just not an option for someone like you and someone like me. But it's also not necessary, so that studio. Call me a production witch doctor because I'm going to show you how to bring your bedroom mix back from the dead. If you're forced to mix in headphones because that's the reality for many of us, I got you. I want to teach you how to get the best mixes that will translate on any system, big or small. But don't just take my word for it. I want to prove to you that these techniques work. Let's test how good your ears are. See if you can hear the difference. One of the two songs I'm about to play was mixed in headphones here in this bedroom. And the other song was made in a multi-million dollar studio in Los Angeles. Here we go. No echoes in the desert. Little did you know, I created Baby Shark in these headphones. Obviously, I'm kidding. It was the first song that was made in these headphones, so it is possible to create quality. But being completely honest with you, there are a lot of disadvantages that come with working in headphones. In order to achieve quality, you need to understand what those are, and more importantly, how to fix them or avoid them. I'm gonna move quick here, so really pay attention because you're just not gonna get the end result you want if you skip any of these middle steps. Not all headphones are created equal, and investing in a good pair of studio headphones is just worth more than you buying another plugin or another sample pack. There are so many great affordable options out there, but you wanna get the right pair for you. You have to consider your own situation and purpose for using these headphones. Is it to record instruments or vocals, or are you producing and mixing in a noisy environment? In this case, closed back headphones might be a better option for you. Because the outer shell is closed, the sound won't bleed into a microphone during a recording, or if you're in like a noisy, loud room, it can prevent those sounds from distracting you. If your main use for headphones is going to be to produce in your quiet bedroom, sort of like me here, then open back headphones might be the better option for you. These typically do sound a bit more natural, and they can allow you to work for longer periods of time because they're not closed. You can see it sort of has like a mesh screen here, but this allows you to work longer because you're not stuck hearing the sound between your head. The other big issue I ran into was no matter what pair of headphones I used, I found that my mixes weren't translating to other systems or devices. Until I learned this. Have you ever noticed every pair of headphones sound different? Some pairs might emphasize the high end to make things sound brighter, or other pairs will boost the low end to make your song sound fatter than it really is. This is because all headphones have their own built-in EQ curve. Comparing the two pairs of headphones that I own, look at how each of them color my sound. This is the Beyer Dynamic DT770s, and here's what the Sennheiser HD650s are doing. When I'm in the DAW mixing, I'm hearing things after these headphones have done these boosts and cuts. So am I hearing my actual mix, or am I hearing my mix after this EQ curve that's specific to only my pair of headphones? Do you see the problem here? What I'm hearing from these headphones is not what my audience is going to hear. 99% of them are not listening to my song with the same pair of headphones that have that same EQ curve. This is why your mixes tend to sound like shit when you play them back on so many different speakers and devices. Here's the solution. For mix translation, you want to be able to hear true sound. You want what is called a flat frequency response. This is that level playing field that all pairs of speakers and headphones will then color the sound from. So if you can make things sound good on a flat spectrum, it will typically translate across the board. Great, but how do you achieve this in your specific pair of headphones? Welcome to the chat, SoundID Reference. The software runs as a standalone app, or it can be used as a plugin on your master chain. All you do is load up the pair of headphones you have, and the software will create an EQ counter curve to make them as flat as possible. I've been using this for like 5 or 6 years now, and seriously, it's the best purchase I've ever made being a bedroom producer. All right, this next one is a problem. A big problem. Let's talk about mixing low-end frequencies like kick and bass in your headphones. Question for you. When you go to the club, do you have to put your ear up against the subwoofer to understand what's going on in the low end for that song? Of course, we all do it, right? Do you understand if you did that, you probably wouldn't be able to hear the words coming out of my mouth right now? We understand that sub and low end frequency through feeling and absorption. It's like the same thing when you're in your car. But what do you do when you're mixing low end in headphones? You're just listening and trusting what your ears tell you. What you hear will not end up being the same thing you feel when it gets played back on a bigger system. Let me help you out because there is a trick to make sure your low end is at the correct levels. I want to quickly just pause to say thank you for watching the video. And if you're ever interested in working with us at Cosmic Academy, I'm going to put a comment pinned below. We've been working with artists just like yourself for over 10 years now, and the results have been incredible. The students we work with, they play some of the biggest shows, EDC, Ultra, Tomorrowland. They sign to some of the biggest labels across all genres, Spinnin', Monster Cat, Armada, Drum Code, many, many, many more. So if you're looking for help and you're serious about music production, check that link below. What you want to do to get started is look at the kick and bass levels from some of your favorite reference tracks in the genre you work in. To do this, I like to use the free plugin Voxengo Span, and I'm going to first turn it into high res mode so I could actually see the detail of what kick and bass are doing. I am way quieter. And that's because those reference tracks, they're mastered. So of course my mix is going to be showing a quieter level. We need to fix this. What I want to do is bring my song up using a limiter to sort of simulate a master. This would show me roughly where my kick and bass are going to sit in the end. Now looking at what I have in my song, I'm pretty damn close. It looks good, and truthfully, it also sounds good. This is the key. You want both of those things. You can't just trust your ears and say, oh, this sounds good, because your headphones lie. And you also can't just trust your eyes in saying, this looks good, because you could make something look good on a frequency spectrum and it sounds like shit. I wanna continue on this topic of referencing because this next step is the most crucial to getting your mix right if you're using headphones. Check this out. When I flip between my song and the reference songs, notice there's a general similarity between them all. Close, right? Although my track doesn't sound exactly like any of the others, it fits in. And that's what your goal should be, to fit in. Here are the steps you could take to get your mix balanced correctly. I had to make an entire video on this because it's that important. So tap the box on screen and let's get your mix fixed.